Hey guys, it's Alex with Engineering Applied. In this video, I'll be helping you boost your Autodesk Inventor proficiency by giving you an overview of the available modification tools within a 2D sketch. If you're looking for a specific function, make sure you check the description for timestamps. And if this video doesn't contain what you're looking for, make sure you check the other videos within the series because I think you'll find exactly what you need. Also, don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on channel notifications so that you don't miss out on any future helpful content like this. Without any further delay, let's go ahead and jump into the video. Okay, so we have our part window open, and the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna create a 2D sketch. So we go up to start 2D sketch, and I'm gonna go ahead and create it on the XY plane. This is completely arbitrary, it really doesn't matter. And to demonstrate the first tool within the modify section, we're gonna actually take a look at move. And before we do that, I'm gonna just draw up a quick little rectangle here. And I'm gonna leave it unconstrained because I wanna make a point about how move actually operates with geometry in the sketch plane. So first we're gonna go over and click on move. And you'll see some options within a little dialog box that pops up. The first option is select. So for select, essentially what this does is it allows us to select the sketch elements that we actually want to move. So if I click this leg, it's going to move that leg independently, and so on and so forth. I actually want to move the whole thing, so I can individually click, or I could come back up to move and just click and drag over the whole thing. So we're going to do that. And then this next little box here is base point. So essentially what base point is it says, hey, this is the reference point in which I want to move the part about. So in this case, if I grab the bottom right-hand corner and I click there, I'm able to move this part via the right-hand corner, the bottom right-hand corner. And so I could click this and drag it over to the origin and it'll snap to the origin. And you know, that's one use for it. And other thing I can do here is I can go to copy. So if I check off the copy field, essentially what this will do is when I highlight this and go to translate it, it creates a copy of the geometry. So this is a pretty handy tool. So the next available function within the move command is the optimize for single selection. So essentially what this does is we can click on one design element or one circle element, line element, or whatever that might be, and it automatically snaps to the base point selection tool. So in this case, I could just click on the circle and it automatically goes to the base point tool and I could just select the center. Now, if that wasn't checked off, what would happen is if I select the outer line and you'll notice that the select tool is still toggled and we would have to manually toggle the base point tool and then come over and do this as well. So it just helps you expedite the process of using this tool if you're not picking up a bunch of separate sketch elements separately. We have precise input, and what precise input allows us to do is it allows us to translate the sketch geometry with X and Y coordinates, an X coordinate and an angle off the Y axis, a coordinate and an angle off the X axis, and some other options housed within there. So we'll click our outer profile. Our base point we're just gonna select is the center because I wanna translate it about the center. Go to precise input and you'll see I get these XY coordinates. So say I wanna move it one unit in the X direction and one unit in the Y direction. And in this case, my default units are in inches. So when I type in one, it means 1 inch in the X direction and 1 in the Y. So doing that, you'll see that my profile has translated 1 in the X axis direction and 1 in the Y axis direction. If I go back to precise input, the drop down at the top, you'll see several different options for what type of coordinates I can use. Over here, we have a reset to origin button. And essentially what this does is it resets the origin with reference to this move command or this translation command back to the origin of the sketch plane. So this is useful if I want to use the origin of the sketch plane to define where I want this part to move. So maybe if I want to move it to 0.5 and 0.5, my delta will reflect that based off of the current origin location. And you can see that where the axis is placed. So I'll go back up here and type 0.5. And you'll see it's moved with reference to the visible axis. And in this case, it's centered at the origin. Okay, the next command is copy. So when we click copy, it works similarly to our move command in that we select the profile that we actually want to copy, and we select the base point in which we want to move that copied profile off of. So we'll select the circle, and we'll zoom in on that just a tad. We'll go over to base point, click on the center, and we can copy the part as many times as we'd like. And then when we're done, we can click done, and it leaves everything there. Now, another option we have is clipboard. And you'll see that when we click this, and let's say we click this profile, click base point, and we'll go ahead and just, we'll actually go ahead and copy it once, and we'll select done. But the nice thing about this is it copies that profile to the clipboard as if you highlighted it and pressed ctrl+C, which is the shortcut to copy something. And you'll notice I'm pressing ctrl+V here, and I can press it a bunch of times, and it copies all of those shapes as if I had manually pressed ctrl+C before I did that operation. We also have the optimize for single selection. This works exactly how it does in the move command. And we have precise input, which also works similarly to that in the move command. So we'll just select a profile, select a base point as the center of that circle, and then we can assign an X and Y coordinate. So we have that option as well. The next command is the rotate command. I'm going to select the profile in which I want to rotate, which it would be the ellipse itself. And I'll actually click and drag the whole thing to get the center point in there. Since it's a point, it really doesn't matter. But I just like to click and drag over the whole profile so I don't actually miss something when I'm moving a little bit faster. Our center point. So for our center point, we can either select it manually. So it could be the center of our ellipse. So if I click that, essentially it prompts us and asks us that, hey, you know, the geometry that we're editing here could be constrained to other geometry. Can we loosen up the constraints there so that we can actually perform this command? And we want to go ahead and hit yes. And when we do that, it freely allows us to rotate our part around the center point I selected. In this case, it was the center point of the ellipse. Now, what happens if we select something other than the center point of the ellipse? Well, if we go back and select the profile and then we select center point, and let's say we want the center point to be like somewhere out here for the rotation. We're going to click yes. And you'll see that it rotates about that arbitrary center point that I selected out in space. We can also go to precise input. And this works similarly to the other move and copy options where, you know, we'll select a profile. And then for our center point, we can type in X and Y coordinates instead of actually selecting something with our mouse cursor. So in this case, maybe we want to rotate around 0, -1. We'll click yes, and it'll rotate around that point. Next, we have our trim tool. And what you see here is two interwoven rectangles. And what our objective here is I want to trim away this corner in this corner so that it's one continuous line. So what I can do is I go to trim, and you can use trim a couple different ways. The first way is you can hover over the leg that you want to trim, and it gives you a preview of what it's actually trimming out of your sketch by showing it as a dashed line. So if I click this here, you'll see that it trims this line and creates a coincident constraint with the endpoint of this line and this line here that's running vertically. I can also click and drag, and you'll see a little faint blue line that shows me where I am trimming. This is similar to the power trim in SolidWorks, if you're familiar with that software. So I can click and drag through here, and it'll eliminate the line. So it's a nice, speedy way of doing that, and pretty convenient. Okay, and now we have extend, and what extend does is it allows us to extend a line segment up to a predetermined point based on the surrounding geometry. So in this example, let's say I wanted to extend this vertical line here on the left side down to the same height that this horizontal line resides. So if I just hover over this, it shows me a little preview. I just left click and it auto generates that line for me. So maybe if I want to close this shape, all I have to do is hover over this one and click on that, and you see it closes it for me. Now, what we can also use this for is, say I have a broken line segment somewhere in my sketch. I can just come up to extend, hover over this, and it completes it for me. So really handy tool, really nice way of matching line lengths with other geometry without having to go in and manually do other types of constraints like a coincident or a parallel or a horizontal constraint or anything like that. We have the split command, and what this does is it splits a continuous line segment up into separate sections if there's intersecting geometry. So I'll show you what this means. If we hover over the circle here, you'll see two little red X's where this horizontal line intersects with the circle. So if I were to click here, it breaks the top segment of the circle into its own section. And you can see that with the little yellow endpoint indicators here. And then the bottom section is separate. And then the same with the line. This endpoint to this endpoint is separate from the middle section and this endpoint. To demonstrate the next tool, which is scale, I went ahead and dimensioned a rectangle to dimensions of 0.5 inches by 0.250. So what we're gonna do is we'll click scale and we'll select the profile that we actually wanna scale, which is the whole rectangle. And we wanna click the base point in which it originates the scale function from. So I'll just click this bottom right-hand corner. We're gonna click yes here. And we can either click and drag the mouse and you actually see the dimensions changing on the fly as I rescale this. So say for example, if I wanted the scale factor to be 4, because I want the side that is a quarter of an inch to be 1 inch, I would just type in a 4 and then enter. And you'll see now that the side is 1 inch and the side is 2 inches. So we get some other options as well. We have precise input, which works similarly to the other tools we've already covered. And then we have the optimize for single selection, which works like the same selection for move, copy, and rotate. Next is stretch. So what we're going to do with stretch is I'll delete these dimensions here. And you can actually lengthen or shorten various segments within your profile based on your selection. So say for example, I wanted to stretch these two legs somewhere off in space. I can select these two. We'll click our base point as this intersecting point here at the vertex. We'll click yes. And you'll see I can click and drag that anywhere in space. Now, what I can also do is if I go back to stretch and I click this vertical line and the base point I can click as this top point. Now I can move this individually. It's not so useful in this particular case, but I just wanted to show you that because it does behave differently based on your selections. Additionally, we get our precise input option, which works, like I said, similarly to the other options that we've seen before, and then optimize for single selection. The final command we have in this session is the offset command. So to demonstrate this, I'll go ahead and draw a rectangle. And we just click offset. And essentially what offset does is it takes a profile and creates a set amount of distance offset with new geometry outside or inside of that profile. So if I hover over this, it gives me a preview of what it's selecting. I just left click and I can either offset it outwards or I can offset a new line inwards. And I can also pre-dimension this so I don't have to come back and do the dimensions later. So I'll do that here. Let's say I want a half inch offset of this new geometry on the outside of the original profile. So I just type in 0.5, press enter, and now I have that new offset. And it's as simple as that. That concludes this segment of the Autodesk Inventor part creation tutorial module. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications to stay up to date on future content as it's released. And as always, don't hesitate to reach out and let me know if there's anything else you'd like to learn about or see on this channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon.